Hi friends, in the last video we have seen the fuzzy relations, cardinalities, Cartesian product, operations, properties and compositions. And in this video let us see the problems on Cartesian product and composition, how these two will be worked out as per problems are concerned. Directly if you have given the fuzzy sets or fuzzy relations, then how you can how you can make the Cartesian product and how you can make the composition, that will be seen in this video. Let us see with the first problem. This is problem 1. Let two fuzzy sets are as follows. If this is a fuzzy set and this is another fuzzy set, and find the Cartesian product of these two fuzzy sets. Okay, we have the formula directly. Mu r is equal to mu a cross b of x comma y is equal to minimum of mu a of x comma y mu b of x comma y. That means we need to see the minimum value out of these things. But before that, how to see the minimum value? Here there are three values and here there are only two values. Then how to see the minimum value? First we need to arrange the fuzzy sets properly for getting the Cartesian product. The arrangement should be, the A should be a column vector and B should be a row vector. That should be the procedure. Let us see how it will be. This is the procedure. This is A and the values are 0.2, 0.5 and 1. It's a 3 by 1 matrix, and B vector, this is a row matrix, this is 1 by 2 matrix. So just like matrix multiplication, this is 3 by 1 and this is 1 by 2. So 1 and 1 will get cancelled. Then it will be 3 by 2. So the Cartesian product should be of 3 by 2 matrix. It's a 3 by 2 matrix. So let us see the minimum, how to find the minimum value. Just like matrix multiplication, in point we need to see minimum value of 0.2 and 0.3. So this is, we need to see the row of A and we need to see the column of B. So the first element is minimum of 0.2 and 0.3. So the first element should be, one element should be 0.2. Now I like to find the 1, 2 element. That element should be minimum of 0.2 and 0.9. So it will be 0.2. Next, that is over. For 1, 1 element is over and 1, 2 element is over. Now I like to see 2, 1 element. For 2, 1 element I need to see the second row and first column. So the second row is 0.25 and the first column is 0.2. So the minimum of these two is 0.3, so the value is 0.3. And in the next step, 2, 2 element, second row, second column. So the minimum of 0.5 and 0.9 is 0.5. Next, 3, 1 element, minimum of 1 and 0.3, value is 0.3. Next, 3, 2 element, minimum of 1 and 0.9, the value is 0.3. That will be written like this: A cross B, 0.2, next step again 0.2, 0.3, 0.5, 0.3, 0.9. So this is the thing. In this way we need to find the Cartesian product. So you have been given two fuzzy sets, and the first fuzzy set you need to make it as a column vector or column matrix. And in the second fuzzy set, you need to make the row vector or row matrix. Then, just like matrix multiplication, you need to identify the elements. And once elements have been identified, and that will be according to the formula, you need to find the minimum of those two. Very simple concept. Okay, that's it. This is the thing. This is the final answer, A cross B. Okay, now let us move on to Cartesian, that means compositions. How the compositions? will be how to find the compositions. This is second problem. Yeah, these are the universes. Capital X is a universe, in that elements are x1, x2. Capital Y is another universe, the elements are y1, y2. Capital Z is another universe, the elements are z1, z2 and z3. Okay, these are the universes, I mean elements in the universes have been described, that's all. Now the relation between the elements will be described by using relational matrices. The relations between them are given as R. R is the relation between X and Y, and the relation is like this. Similarly, S is the relation between Y and Z, and the relation is like this. Then what we need to find out? We need to find the composition by max mean method and max product methods. Let us see how to find the compositions. Yeah, this is the formula for max mean method. First we have to see the minimum of a value in U in relation R and the relation S. We need to see the minimum of these two, and then we need to go ahead with the maximum. Okay, let us see how it will be. Yeah, this is R and this is S. Just like matrix multiplication, we need to see the row of the first relational matrix and column of the second relational matrix. And I need to see I need to apply the above formula. First, let me see, the first element is 0.7 and the first element in S is 0.9. So out of these two, the minimum is 0.7. Please keep like that. And in the next step, 0.5, I need to see the row here in R and I need to see column in S. So here the elements are 0.5 and 0.1. Minimum value is 0.1. In the above step, the minimum value is 0.7. Below step, the minimum value is 0.1. Now I have two values, one is 0.7 and 0.1. Now I need to find the maximum of these two. Obviously it is 0.7. So that is the first value. Yeah, that is the first value. Here he has given something, he has given x1 and z1. Okay, same what we have done now, he has given the same thing. So the value is 0.7. So again we can see that, likewise we can identify all the values. So if you have any doubts, please write in the comment box so that I can explain you. This is the thing for max mean method. For max product method, we need to see the product of the elements from R and S. Let us see how it will be. So we have already taken the R and S here. So same thing here, the example is x2 and z2. We will also see the same thing, x2 and z2. Here x2 elements are 0.8 and 0.4 and z2 elements are 0.6 and 0.7. Okay, let us see. We need to take the product. So 0.8 into 0.6 is 0.46, I mean 48, and the second one is 0.4 and 0.7. So the value is 0.28. So 0.48 and 0.28. So the maximum of that will be 0.48. So this is the value. Similarly, we need to find each and everything, and the final value is like this. Okay, this is the thing for max product method. This is the solution for composition of two relations, and previously we have seen the Cartesian product of two fuzzy sets. Okay, with this the problematic part is completed. If you have any doubts, please mention in the comment box so that I can go ahead with another video with my own hand and writing on the paper. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you for 1100 plus subscriptions till date, and please like this video if you like it, and if you share it, please share with your friends and family. If you haven't subscribed till date, kindly subscribe to the YouTube channel and please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you. Thank you.